Hey humans, this is Kathleen, your embedded librarian. I'm making a quick video to shed light on how one goes about identifying magazines and newspapers on a particular topic. So let me start at the MJC webpage because I know you can all get there. I think I've showed you before that you just click on the old pile of books to get to the library. And then you select articles and databases to get to our database page. Now, the last part of this project had you using Gale eBooks. This part of the project will have you focusing on EBSCOhost databases and Gale databases. We call EBSCO and Gale our superstore databases because they contain a lot of different types of information, magazine articles, newspaper articles, journal articles, encyclopedia articles, reports, etc. I'm going to do a little search here for religious, if I could spell, tolerance. There we go. I'm going to do search. And like all of our databases, you type in your topic, you get a list of results. Now with EBSCO, your job is to tell the database that you want to look at magazines and newspapers. So right here, when you do a search on EBSCO, to the left will be this link to source types. So I'm simply going to choose magazines. And if you want, you can also choose newspapers. Okay. And this is, I feel like this is going to be the most challenging part, is you might actually have to scroll, you know, through a few pages of information to find something that's really interesting, right? I like this article right here, God and Country. And the reason I like it is because I can read a little abstract and I can see that this article explores the history of religious tolerance in the United States. And even though I may be exploring this topic as it relates to a past age, I know that one of my prime objectives is to tie issues from that past age to today. And so learning about religious tolerance in a past age and then applying that to how that concept of religious tolerance has played out in American history is interesting to me. Now, in EBSCO, you will usually have the choice between PDF and HTML. In this case, I just have HTML, so I'm going to click on that HTML, and what should appear is the magazine article. Okay, and from here, I can send this article to Google Drive, I can print it, I can email it, I can save it, and I can cite it in a variety of formats. I can also listen to it, okay? So this is an example of how to find a magazine article on one of your concepts in EBSCOhost. The next database I want to show you quickly is Gale databases. Gale databases, you're familiar with Gale because of Gale eBooks. I find the Gale Power Search, which is cool because it searches like 24 different Gale databases. I find it a little tricky to search. Sometimes, I'm just saying. So I'm going to put in Ezra Pound, who is a figure, a big figure, I think, in modernism here. And Gale works a little differently. Gale will still give me full text articles, relevance ranked, but do you see here right up top it says showing results for magazines. So I don't have to click any boxes. These are magazines, right? And if I want to look at newspaper articles, I can go to newspaper articles. So I'm going to go to magazines because I thought this was an interesting, I love Smithsonian, and this looks like an interesting title. Ezra Pound's a fascinating person. I have a love-hate relationship with Mr. Pound. Anyway, here is this entire article on Ezra Pound. And you're probably familiar with the Gale interface just from using Gale eBooks. From here, I can send this article to Google Drive or OneDrive, or email it or download it, send it to myself here, and again, cite it in a variety of formats. I can see right here, strange, inscrutable case. Those words should be capitalized. I think I've warned you in the past that with database self-citation tools, the name of the game is copy, paste, and fix. So I would copy this, paste it, and what I would fix is strange and inscrutable and case. I would capitalize those words. I don't think you're really worried about citation now, if I remember correctly. Oh, my screen just went black. That was dramatic. Well, there we go. So I think that's it. So again, just to review, you're going to want to start at MJC. Okay, if you have to start at MJC, click on Library, click on Articles and Databases. EBSCO and Gale are the two databases that will be most useful for this particular part of the project. EBSCO, you will do your search and then definitely go down to source types and choose magazines and newspapers. And Gale will present magazines to you as their default retrieval set, and you can choose newspapers if you need. This may be the most challenging part of the assignment so far, depending on what concept, what feature, what person you decide to research. So be flexible, and again, don't forget that you can always contact me, or you can come to our Ask a Librarian and open up a chat, give us a call, text us, email, whatever. We will be available Monday through Thursdays, 9 a.m. to 7 p.m., Fridays and Saturdays, 10 to 3 on our online suite of services. If you want to talk to a person, a real live research librarian, you'll need to come in Monday through Thursdays, 9 to 7, East Campus Fridays 10 to 3, and West Campus Saturdays 10 to 3. Okay, get in touch if you need help. Good luck with the next part of the project.